Thank you, Jesus, for yet another opportunity giving me, Lord, to speak your word. The word that we might not be wayward. Blessed be your holy name, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I'm just a little boy that I'll be set to use, O God, in this generation. Use me to your glory in the name of Jesus Christ. In the grace to speak your word, O God. Father, your word and your word alone in the name of Jesus. Without fear of favor, without looking at faces, without, O God, blabbing in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Abba Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Father, once again, I put my ears in your mouth. Speak to me, that you might speak to me. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And let's turn our Bible to the book of Genesis, chapter number. Exodus chapter number 1 from 8 to 14. Exodus chapter 1, 8 to 14. Exodus chapter 1, 8 to 14. And I read. Now there arose a new king over Egypt, which knew not Joseph. And he said unto his people, Behold, the people of the children of Israel are more than and more and mightier than we. Come up, all deal wisely with them. Praise Mother Jesus. Come on, and let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply. And it came to pass that when they fall out any war, we join also unto our enemies and fight against us. And so get them up out of the land. Therefore they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them. Mark that place. Therefore they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them with burdens, and they built for Pharaoh treasures, cities, Pithom and Ramses. But the more they afflict them, the more they multiply and grew, and they were grieved because of the children of Israel. And the Egyptians made the children of Israel to serve with vigor. Slavery. They made them to serve with vigor. Burden. And they made their life bitter. Hard bondage. They made their life bitter with hard bondage in mortar, and in bricks, and in all manner of service, in the field, all their service, wherein they made themselves was with rigor. Praise Master Jesus. I come into verse 14. And they made their life bitter with hard bondage, in mortar, in bricks. And in all manner of service in the field, all their service, wherein they made themselves, was with rigor. Hallelujah. Now, I go again to Exodus chapter number 16. Exodus chapter number 16, verse 1 to 3. Exodus 16, verse 1 to 3. After the Lord has set them free from those vigorous work, after that bondage. Now, 16, Exodus 16, 1 to 3. And they took their journey from Elim, and all the congregation of children of Israel came unto the wilderness of Sin, which is between Elim and Sinai, on the 15th day of the second month, after their departing out of the land of bondage, after their departing out of the land of vigorosity, after departing from the land of squalor. Now, and the whole congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses. And the whole congregation of Israel murmured against Moses, against their master. Praise God, Jesus. Okay, hallelujah. when I bring like somebody's calling. The whole congregation of Israel murmured against Moses and Aaron in their wilderness. And the children of Israel said unto them, Would to God we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots, and when we did eat bread to the full. For you have brought us forth into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Hallelujah. Forgetting everything they were going through. Now, the topic today says, slaves that love their chains. Slaves that love their chains. These are the people we just have here right now. Slaves that love their chains. The Bible makes us understand in the first place we read in Exodus chapter 1, 8 to 13 to 14. How rigorous their pain was. How suffering they were in the land of Egypt. The taskmaster that was surrounding them, they were made to suffer, to work unconditionally. And the Bible said the Lord set them free from that bondage. And they became masters of their own. They cannot breathe fresh air. They cannot live without nobody constraining them. And the Bible said they came to a place called sin. Because of just little things, because they have not seen food to eat for just some minutes, the Bible said they begin to murmur against Aaron and against Moses. Tell them, we prefer to have died in that place that we were. We prefer to have died in Egypt where we were made to suffer as animals. We prefer to have died in Egypt where we were made to suffer as slaves. Why should you free us now? Why would you allow us to be free? We prefer that, at least in that place. We eat bread in that place that we eat pot in pain, in sorrow. They forgot all the pain that they were going through. They forgot the lashes they were giving to them. They forgot all the distress they were passing through. They begin to murmur against their Savior. Murmuring against God. Slaves that love their chains. They love the pain they were going through in Egypt. They love the task they were forced to embark on in Egypt. Forgetting what the Lord had done for them. Forgetting they don't longer receive Cain in their body anymore. Forgetting their children are no longer raped the way they used to rape them anymore. Slaves that love their chain. That is the kind of Christians we have today. That is the kind of people we have today. Easily forgetful people. People that can easily forget what the Lord has done for them. If there's any little constraint, there's any little shit, they easily forget what God has done for them. Yesterday they sing Hosanna, 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 they spread tears on the ground for him. And tomorrow they begin to crucify him. We don't know him. Who made him God of us? That is a Christian we have today. People who can easily change much by second bill. In the morning when the Lord is working miraculously, they say, hey, yes, God is our God. But in the afternoon when they say, okay, let me watch them and see, they begin to call Baba, Father again, they used to call in Nigeria. They only come to God with their body, but all their fingers, all those things are still their fingers. The atrocious mind is still with them. The mind to go to native doctors is still with them. The Bible says these people, they easily remember the bread they were eating in Egypt. Forgotten the sorrow they were going through. They can easily remember those onions in pain they were eating, but forgotten the bondage they were made to be. And that is a Christian we have today. That is the life most of us are living today. We can easily forget things. Any little time we pray today that things have not happened, we remember that Baba in Ajegunle. We forgot the bondage they have placed on. We forgot the spiritual freedom that the Lord has given to us. Slaves that love their chains. Well, who is a slave? It is somebody who is not free. You are not free to do what you ought to do. You are not free to live the kind of life you want to live. Somebody is placed by your side, a taskmaster. That is the life sinners are living. Sinners are slaves to the devil. Whoever is living in sin, you are a slave to the devil. Devil have put you in perpetual bondage. Praise Master Jesus. And whenever God set us free, because of one thing he has not done, we prefer to go back to the devil. We prefer to go back to native daughter. We prefer to go back to the fake prophet. Forgetting the bondage that you wear. Forgetting the pain that you'll be going through there. Chains. The slave that love that chain. What is the chain? The chain is sin. You are in bondage. And Satan have used sin to encroach you. You have been encroached in that bondage. And yet, you say, I want to be free, but you love the sin that you are committing. You love those things you are doing. You want to be free, but yet you don't want to leave the sin you are committing. Praise Father Jesus. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1 to 3, say, woe to the rebellious children. Woe, curse be unto the rebellious children. Say the Lord of hosts, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to their sin, that walk to go down into Egypt, that walk to go back to where they were free from. Woe unto the man that turned their back on Canaan land. Woe unto the man that turned their back on heaven and faced bondage again. Seeking counsel from pastors who are not doing the will of God, you are in perpetual bondage. After the Lord has spoken to you, after you have gotten the right gospel from any church, you know that they are preaching the right gospel, you go back to a pastor who can help you to dilute it. You go back to somebody who can help you to streamline the gospel. Say, woe unto you. Woe unto you. You that know the right thing to do, but because of your flesh, you talk to somebody who can help you to bring that so you can make your heart happy. Maybe the Lord tell you, don't go there all the time. Go sometimes. So that you will not hear the gospel of righteousness. You know what you do? Maybe if the man is too hot, don't always call him. Call him sometimes. Whenever he's preaching the message, you say, you are blessed. Tomorrow you can connect that time. Say, woe unto such people who are looking for a place where they will help them to streamline the gospel of God. Who are looking for a place where they will help them to dilute Jesus. Whoever that dilute the word of God is diluting Jesus. And whoever that try to dilute Jesus will be diluted. He will dilute you in hellfire. Woe! Woe unto you, a rebellious children. Share the Lord, not Apostle Emmanuel. Who seek to dilute the gospel of God to make the people happy? Woe unto any pastor who try to dilute the word of God to make them to remain in their perpetual bondage, because they know the children of this generation are the children who are slaves that love their chain. Even when God is telling them, no, let me pull the chain from you, say, no, leave the chain from me. Let the chain be. Who take counsel but not of me? And that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit. Not of my spirit. The spirit of God is always truthful. The spirit of God will not try to pet you to perish you. No.
The Spirit of God will not look at your faith before he preached to you. No. The Spirit of God will not check your status before he started to you. No. No matter what you have done, give the president 10 billion euros. He will tell you what not to tell you. That is the Spirit of God. The day a man starts looking at your face before talking to you, that means the Spirit of God has departed. Jesus Christ can never be afraid of anybody, no matter who you are. Woe, woe, woe unto any man that wants to dilute Jesus. Say that they may add sin to their sin. Whoever that removed from the word of God is adding sin to sin. Whoever that tried to pet somebody, to pet any sin, I tell you, you are shed from that sin. The Bible says in Isaiah 30 verse 2 now, that thought that work to go down into Egypt, that work to go back to their sin, and have not asked at my mouth. Hey, man, to break the table. Have not asked at my mouth to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh. Whoever is happy in sin, you are strengthening yourself in the strength of Pharaoh. You know you are living in sin, and you are joyful. You are joyfully living in sin. You are looking for somebody who can help you to streamline. They say we should not wear earring. Okay, what do I do? Okay, just put on one ear, in the other ear. He is killing you. Don't go there. Because the gospel there is too hot. You should not go there. He's killing you. That is the wisdom of Pharaoh. You that abide and he that abide, I take it, both of you are in dungeon. That is the word of God. And to trust in the shadow of Egypt, trust in the shadow of sin, trust in the shadow of fake prophets. Say, therefore, shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame. Hey, Matthew, break it. Shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame? Shall the strength of sin be your shame? You will die in hell if you don't repent. Slaves that love that chain. Jesus wants to set you free. Jesus wants to set me free. And we are saying, yes, we want to be free, but leave the chain in my neck. And just enjoy the chain. And what we do, Lord Jesus Christ, and make the chain longer. So I can go some far. Let me go a little far distance. Slavery is slavery. Bondage is bondage. There's nothing like being free. When you are a slave, you are a slave. When as long as you are under the coverage of Satan, you are a slave. All sinners are slaves to the devil. Slaves that love that chain. You tell them, this is what the Lord is saying. Run away from there. No, because whenever I go there, I see the man of God the way he laughs. And we say, glory to God, glory to God. That's, I want to see a slave that love that chain. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18 to 19. Say, for as much as you know that you were not redeemed with corruptible things. That is, if you are actually sure you are born again, if you are actually sure you are the redeemed, not fabricational redeemed, not chameleon redeemed, you are here on the mountain, you pretend as if you are born again, you pray a very long prayer, you see the prayer we prayed just now, Father, have mercy on those virtuous women who are hypocrites, who pretend as if they have removed what they removed, but in them they are doing what they are doing. You are doing yourself, you are not doing Apostle Emmanuel. You are not doing Apostle Tongue. We only preach what the Lord said we should preach. You are not doing Apostle Abraham, another Apostle Peace. We are only commissioned to tell you. And if we that are telling you we are still doing what you are preaching, hey, I tell you, we are only digging our grave, and that will not be our portion in the name of Jesus. But if we not tell the truth, you go to a place where they will help you to dilute you. No problem, they will dilute you in that sulfuric fire in hell. Therefore, as much you were not redeemed with corruptible things, as silver and gold, from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Jesus Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. This is our redemption package. Our redemption package is a package without blemish. We were not saved by all these things, this gold and silver. We are saved by the blood of Jesus. So why don't we remain saved? Why don't we obey and keep this? The Bible says, now that the Lord has set you free, don't ever go back to bondage again. But we are saying, no, we will remain in bondage because we love the chain. We love the chain. We want to remain where we are. Okay, let Father just pronounce us saved, but actually we know we are not saved. Sister, you are looking at me now. Brother, you are hearing me. You know who you are. You know you are not actually born again. The chain of sin is still your neck. You are still a slave. You can't hide it from God. I cannot hide it from God. If I'm here right now, I'm shouting. The Lord knows my intent of heart. He knows who I am. If I'm just preaching it now, and the trumpet sound, I'm not doing what I'm preaching, I have no boy to blame. We were not redeemed by corruptible things. So why are we still corrupting ourselves with them? Why are we still gallivanting with them? Why are we still allowing the things of this world to put us in perpetual bondage? Let us get off of slavery. Yesterday we were slaves to the devil. Now that we say we are free, let us remove the chain from our neck. Let us do away with the taskmaster. All those pastors, all those people who are streamlined, they are taskmasters to us. Pharaoh said, okay, what do we do? Now we can see light coming somewhere. We can see if we leave these people now, they will know the truth. So what do we do? Let us set taskmaster ahead of them. Now, that pastor who is telling you what is not real, who is trying to pet you, is only a taskmaster in a disguise. Any man that will advise you wrongly, who will not tell you the truth, the total truth, because he wants to be happy in the flesh, is a taskmaster in disguise. Run from such a person. Don't allow them to pull the yoke of bondage your neck. What they will do, they will only add to the rope. You will think you are free now. My Jesus. Jesus. That is what they do. You are not actually free. They pronounce freedom on you, but meanwhile they only extended the rope for you because you are a slave that loves the chain. Because they know you are a slave that loves the chain, they only pronounce freedom. Meanwhile they know you aren't free. The Bible says in Galatians chapter, because I'm telling you, I have no time, Galatians chapter 4 verse 8. 11. They have it then, where you know not God, you did serve unto them which by nature are not gods. But now, after that, you have no God, or rather, are no of God. How turn ye again to the weak and beggarly elements, where unto you dare desire again to be in bondage? You observe days and months and times. And yes, I am afraid of you, lest I have bestowed upon you labor in vain. Children of God, is Apostle Emmanuel laboring in vain? Is Apostle Tangod laboring in vain? Is Apostle Abraham and the prayer band laboring in vain? Please don't let us labor in vain, I beg you. Now the Lord is using us to tell you the truth. Why will you turn back to your folly? Why will you turn back to your bondage? Where they only enlarge, they only add there to the rope. They have not cut the rope off. But after that, you have known. After that, you have known the truth now. After that, you have known what God has said now. Why will you rather go back to sin again? But now, after that, you have known the know God, and rather I know of God. God, I know you, sister. You are no more stranger to God again. Where will you go back to native doctor human form again? What are you still doing in that prostitute house? What are you still doing with drugs in your head? What are you still doing in the lap of a man that's not your husband? What are you still doing in the lap of that woman that's not your wife? Why are you still gallivanting with sin after the Lord has redeemed you? You are playing with danger, sister. You are playing with your soul. God have know you now. You have no God. How turn you again to the weak and beggarly element? Where unto you desire again to be in bondage? Don't be a slave that love that chain. Hate that chain, sister. Hate that chain, brother. That chain is the actual bondage. Without the chain, your master cannot hold you bound. Without that chain, your master cannot hold you. That chain is the rope that puts you that bondage. Let the chain off your neck. Remove those things from your body. All those gold, all those silver. A woman don't wear trousers, remove them. They are only chains. Satan will tell you, don't worry, we have trousers that a woman can wear. Hey, it's only elongating your chain. Just use wool. Use wool to do it. It's only elongating your chain. Use the old thread. Hey, artificial is artificial. Remove them. They have not actually removed the bondage. They only elongated the chain for you. If you are able to walk 50 meters, we extend it to 100 meters for you. You are still in bondage. All roads lead to hell. As long as that chain is in your neck, no matter how distant they give to you now, all roads lead to hell. Run away. He said, I am afraid. Apostle Paul is talking to you and I. He's afraid all the gospel he has written for us has been worked in vain. Have we allowed Apostle Paul to go to Patmos, go to Ephesus, go to Rome, traveling from every in the rain on the road, falling into the sea? He was being stoned because of you and I, that you and I might know the truth. Now we have known the truth, and we are still going back to that perpetual bondage. Don't allow him to walk again. Don't allow Jesus Christ to die again. The Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 18 to 22, I'll just run it over. For when they speak great swelling word of vanity, they tell you vanitious word. They are all vanity. Swelling word. They wear their big suits. Their big trousers, the one they use your money to buy. And they lie to you. They see prophet. They will never see prophet of how God is coming. They only see prophet of how you will back her tomorrow, how your mother will die, and you become your mother in the house. How you are able to do to your husband and make sure that you are not a woman of your own. For when they speak great swelling word of vanity, they allure through the lust of the flesh. They know who you are. They know you are a flesh human being. Before you get it, they have already read you. They know what you are looking for. They know you are looking for bread and butter. So they give you the word according to what you are. According to what you are looking for. To lure you into a perpetual bondage that nobody else can free you from. Jesus, too much water on us. Those that were clean escaped from them who live in error. Run away. So the Bible says in verse 8:19, why they promise thee liberty. Listen, they promise what they don't have. They are not born again. You can't give what you have not. You know them. They are not in Christ Jesus. How can they give you Christ when they are not in Christ Jesus? They can only give you Christ. Why they promise you liberty? They themselves are the servant of corruption. They are only taskmasters, sisters and brothers. Don't listen to them. Any pastor that will preach according to the money you bring is not a pastor. Whoever will look at faith before I preach to you is not a pastor. You know the truth. Set your heart. Whenever pastor is preaching, you already know the truth, but you don't want to live there because you are a slave that loves your chain. You wouldn't want to live there, but your mind is telling you, this man is not telling me the truth.
I've seen many people. I said, what should you attend? Like yesterday, somebody that coming from somewhere. Okay, tell me. This and that. Okay, I said, sir, I know. You know? I am sitting there. And sir, what do I do? I don't know what you should do. I don't know what you should do. If you be in the fire, your house is burning around you. You know there's a road to escape. You are asking, should I run? No, don't run. The fire will consume you and you have no way to blame. That those are slaves that love their chains. These are the Christians we have because of what they can gain now. Because of 2 days of judgment, they prefer to live in perpetual bondage forever. Just give me these 2 days of judgment. Let the next 3 days, let me suffer. The problem that humanity have, they forgot that after today there will be tomorrow. They take 10 years and say this is forever. Even when the prophet or the native God tell them, this enjoyment will last for 5 days, for 5 years, they say, yeah, it will look as if 5 years is very long. And no problem. Taking their wives, and when after that 5 years, I'll go and quickly say, God, help me, Lord. Before that 5 years, Eli, they'll cut you off. They will not allow that 5 years to complete, because they know if you complete, you quickly run to the master, Jesus Christ. They will make sure before that 5 years, they cut you off. Slave that love that chains. For whom a man is overcome, of the same man he brought into bondage. Have you allowed the sweetness of that past to overcome you? You are in his bondage. Have you allowed all those sweet words he's telling you, hey, yes, and God bless you, sister, how are you? Or do you allow that, hey, bam, you are blessed, bam, hey, God say he will bless you, ja. Is that what you want to hear? Where you be, all the house everywhere is looking, they use all those things to deceive you. All those globes they put everywhere, different color of globe, different lights, they measure everywhere, you are in that place, yet you are in hellfire. Many people are in the church, but they are far from the kingdom of God. Many of you people, many of these Christians, they belong to church, but they don't belong to the kingdom of God. Where do you prefer to belong to? You want to belong to a church, and your name is not in the kingdom of God? I tell you, you and that church will be burned down when the time comes. I am a member of a church, but you are not a member of God's kingdom. Shame on you. Shame on you. You want to belong to that conglomerate big church, but you are not in the mansion of heaven. I pity you. They promise you freedom, but meanwhile, they know they are a product of hell. They promise you freedom that will never come. They paid the worst for you. Meanwhile, they know who they are. They are taskmasters sent to put you in bondage. Hallelujah. The Bible says, verse 20, for if after they have escaped the pollution of this world through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein. Hey. See, Sarosley, who is that person? Brother Dennis. I am not playing here, please. Nobody should tell that person to be very careful now. Happiness. Hallelujah. This is like some people don't know what they're facing right now. If this woman know what you are facing, she'll be careful. Verse 16. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 20. For if after they have escaped the pollution of the world, through the knowledge of the word of God, our Savior Jesus Christ, with this word we are just hearing now, this undiluted word of God that Apostle Pete is telling you every day.
And Sister Claire is telling you every day that that pastor you don't recognize somewhere is telling you every day, after they have given you the word of God, and again, you go back and entangle yourself into that bondage. He said, your latter days shall be worse than your beginning. Your punishment that you're about to have will be worse than all those tax matters that you set around you. So what do? The Bible says in Galatians 5 verse 1, don't go back to your sin again. Jesus Christ has set you free. The Lord has set you free. Remain free. Remain in this freedom. Remain in the freedom that Christ has given you. So the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. Those that know the truth and go back to Egypt, whoever turn their back on Canaan land and go back to Egypt, I tell you, when Pharaoh catch you again, you are finished. You know that nobody will come and help you again. Now that you have a savior, he has redeemed you from the land, from the hand of Pharaoh. Don't turn your back on your savior and go back to Pharaoh. He will not spare you. He will tell you how your master destroyed his children in the Red Sea. He will make you to understand what happened to his first son, how the first son died. He will make you to understand how he was in the paradise and he disobeyed his master and went into hellfire. He will make sure he deal with you. Satan will make sure he deal with you squarely, because he will tell you how he lost his paradise in heaven. Don't go to him. The Lord is warning me now. He's warning you now. You have known the truth. Don't go back to sin. Verse 21, for it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness. Sister, do you hear that? It would have been better if you have not known the mountain of solution and revelation premise worldwide, aka shepherd and the bishop of our soul. It would have been better if you were never connected. You connected and know the truth. Because of the truth, you run away because of the truth. I pity you. And I pray that will not be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. May the truth of God not be too heavy in your heart to carry. The after they have not it, to turn from the holy commandment delivered unto them. But it is happened unto them according to the true proverb, the dog is turned to his vomit. The dog is taught to his vomit. Happiness. I'm not happy at all. Hallelujah. But it happened unto them, according to the truth proverb, the dog is turned to his vomit again. And the soul that was washed to her hallowing in the man. Yo, don't be a dog. Don't be a dog. Even sometimes, some dogs want their chain to be removed from them. Even sometimes, you see some dogs, they are struggling. Hey, please remove this thing. Let me get free sometimes. But human being, it baffles me. Human being that's supposed to be wise, they are not doomed. Animals are even wiser than human being now. Animals are not wiser than human being. Human being with no fire is burning, but because of the earthly pressure they put in their head there. Don't go back to your vomit. If standing aloof is as dangerous as moving forward, and moving forward is as dangerous as going back, you better move forward, brother. If standing in one place now, it's as dangerous as going back to where you're coming from. And going back to where you're going from, coming from, is as dangerous as moving forward. You better move forward. If remaining in wilderness is as dangerous as turning back to Egypt again, and going to Egypt is as dangerous as moving to Canaan land, you better move to Canaan land. If Egypt was good for you, you will not go to wilderness. And if wilderness is the best for you,
you don't plan to move forward, you better go to Canaan that you are not seeing. Our Canaan is heaven. No matter the pain of entering heaven, bear the pain. Apostle Peace, God has called you now. No matter the pain, you better stay. Apostle Emmanuel, no matter the stress, you better stay, because where you were was so dangerous to you. Don't go back to those masters. They will not spare you. Sister, I have a lot to say, but time will not permit me. Don't be a slave that loves that chain. This is the word of admonition, the word of exhortation, the word of life. That your father, my father, who shed his blood to make sure you and I are redeemed, have for us tonight. Take heed. Run away from any friend that will advise you wrongly and tell you to dilute the word of God in your heart. Any friend will tell you, don't go there, because if you go there, you hear more. Or go sometimes. It's not a friend. Not a friend. It's better a friend tell you, bear it. It's painful now, but tomorrow it will be gainful. Nothing good come easy. Jesus Christ did not shed his blood easy. The pain that Christ goes through was not easy for him. He is glorified that it was not easy. So going to heaven might not be easy, but bear it. That's why it's called a narrow road and full of thorns. The Lord will help you, he will help me. Remember, it's not of him that preaches, it's him that practicalizes it. It's not of him that hear it, it's him that dwell it. May God help me, may God help you. I may not be a preacher, and at the end, become a signboard. That is not my portion, and you may not be a hearer, and on the last day say, hey, you have heard it, why did you do with it? I pray God help you, God help me. That this word will not be used against us on the last day. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Chain, please have mercy upon me and give me the grace to practice the treasures, that I may not go back to Egypt again, no matter what happens, that I may not murmur against you anymore. Help me, Lord, to run this way to the end. In Jesus' name, open my prayer. Father, I preach your word of God. Help me, Lord, to abide this word of God. Wherever I've murmured against your word, wherever I've think of going back to Egypt again, please have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me, Lord. Have mercy upon my wife and children. Have mercy upon the God of us, God. In the name of Jesus Christ, wherever we have touched our heart of going back to sin, returning back to where we are coming from, please have mercy. We are sorry, Lord. We are sorry, Lord. Have mercy upon us, God. Please have mercy. Give us the grace. Give us the strength, God, to run this way to the end, of God, that we may not think, O God, of going back to Egypt again, of going back to our taskmasters, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, help us, O Lord. Help us to stand strong, to stand firm to the end, of God, in the name of Jesus Christ. They will not be tired of hearing your word. They will not go back to Egypt. They will not turn our back on Canaan, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are facing Canaan. We will never turn our back on Canaan, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Help us, O Lord. Help us, O Lord. In Jesus' glorious name. We are afraid. This word will not be used against us on the last day in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will make the journey easy for us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Brethren, by the grace of God, we meet again 6 a.m. in the morning. If I tarry, but if not, if it comes tonight, I believe with this word, we all are reconciled back here now. We all shall make to heaven in the name of Jesus Christ. It's offering time. Hallelujah. Jam those lovely, those holy hands for Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Sister Esosa. Sister.
Amen.
Close prayer. Huh? God bless you. Close prayer.
Amen. Father, we honor you, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor, we give you all the adoration. We thank you, Lord, for the word we have heard, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, spoke to us in the morning again, you spoke to us again, Father, that you will say thank you for the word, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord, you will not.